the first topic will be bag of words. So bag of words. Okay, so this is something like bag of words. So I will, what I will do is, yeah. Okay, so I will increase this. I will just minimize this for a while. Yeah. Now what I have done is, so everyone just look in the chat box. So I am sending one paragraph to you. Okay, so let's start. So first what we'll do is we will import all the important libraries. Okay. So the first library that we'll work with, import RE. What is RE, guys? Anyone?
Rejects.
Okay, so import NLTK. Then we have to import. So basically we will import all the libraries or all the packages which are essential for pre-processing, okay, or data cleaning or data mining, as you called it, in NLP. So from NLTK dot corpus. So basically the very good part about this IDE is that it gives a suggestion. So if you forgot something, it will help you. You can take that for a suggestion also. So import stop words. Okay, from now we will go with the Portage timer and lemmatizer also. So we will either work with any one of these. So Portage timer or lemmatizer is up to you what you want to work with. So we import both for now. Okay, so NLTK dot stem dot porter import. So NLTK dot stem dot porter import porter stemmer support stemmer, and the same thing copy paste. So lemmatizer, if you remember, there is something called as wordnet lemmatizer in NLTK. So you can use any of the libraries, okay? So I am using NLTK just for a demonstration. You can use PC, you can use any libraries of your choice. Okay, so these are the important libraries that we work with. Now how to, now in a Jupyter notebook, step by step, I have shown with the example that how you do, how you remove stop words and how you convert to lower, then split, then convert. This we have done with the using, with the help of a small example and with the help, with the in one shell, okay? Now how to code for a particular use case. So what we have to do is we have to write a for loop now. Okay, so we have to write a for loop. So the first thing what you have to do is, so can anyone tell me what is the first thing that we have to do for text speech processing? What is the first thing we have to do?
Convert text.
Convert to lower case or upper case.
Okay, so convert into lower case or upper case, and then next.
Tokenization.
Exactly. Okay. So what I will do is, I will use sentence tokenizer. Okay, so how to use sentence tokenizer in NLTK? Any idea? NLTK dot
sent underscore tokenize.
So sent underscore tokenize
and in bracket paragraph dot lower.
Okay, so paragraph dot lower. Okay, so if I run this now, so you can see on the left hand side everything is getting stored. So you can see literally that whether the sentence is converted or not into a lowercase. Okay, so this is a paragraph. So if you double click on that, a new window will get open. So you can see, okay, this is a text, this is a text, and this is the original paragraph variable and the sentence variable. If you double click on that, so you can just compare the two and you can see, okay, everything is converted into sentence tokenizer. Basically it's a list of value now. So this is the first sentence, this is the second sentence, this is the third sentence, four, five, six, and so on. And everything is converted into lowercase. Okay, so that's why I choose Jupyter Notebook because visualization is very easy in Jupyter Notebook. Sorry, not Jupyter, Spider Notebook. Or Spider IDE, sorry. So what is the length of the string? What is the length of the string?
One.
What is the length of sentences?
30 seconds.
So just check, means not don't type and see the length and
31
everything.
is there.
On the right hand side, you can see the length and the size. Okay, so you can just type it as the answer from there. Okay, so we have seen that how to convert to lowercase. Now the question is, so what I want is that I want this particular sentence. Okay, this particular sentence, I want to clean this particular sentence. So basically, you have to remove the stop words. Okay, you have to remove the, after remove the stop words, then just lemmatize this, and then again join the sentence. And I want the same sentence, but the lemmatization should be there and the remove the stop words should be there. Okay, so that's the query for me. So my query is clear to everyone that what is the next procedure that we have to do? Now our aim is to clean the data. So our aim is to clean the data. So lowercase we have done. Now we have to split this, or we have to word tokenize, or anything you can do of your choice. And we have to remove the stop words, and we have to stem or lemmatize. So basically, it's up to you what whether if you want to lemmatize or stemize the word. Okay, so it's up to you. But you got the point. What you have to do? The next, we have to clean the data. Okay, so cleaning the data. So you can apply any method. Okay, now what I will do is I will code parallelly. You can also code in your own way, but at the end you should get the answer. Okay, at the end you should get an answer. So basically you should get a single string, where all the words are concatenated, means all the sentence, you have a proper sentence with the removal of stop words, and the words should be lemmatized. So this is what I will type, and it's up to you. Okay, so what I will do is I will create a dictionary, I will create a list, so corpus, and for I in range. So basically I'm running a for loop through all the list. Okay, so basically I have a list of 31 values, right? So I am running the for loop till there. So length of sentences, then review re dot. So basically I'm using a regular expression, okay, to remove the words, which are present, like is and the and stuff like this. Okay, so any numbers or any words. So okay, so I will leave this. I will not do this regular expression one. Just extra step. Okay, so I will do I know I dot split. I'll split this using I, then review equal to, then I will use a list comprehension basically. So for word in review, if not word in set stop words dot words, and I'm using an English language for there. Okay, so English. So for word in review, if the word is not present in the stop word, so basically I'm just stemming that word. So okay, so one thing we have missed, and that is the instance initialization. Okay, so we have not created any object. Okay, so first we have to create the object. That is important thing, right? So what we'll do is, so we'll do ps equal to quarter stemmer and just call the object, then wordnet equal to word net lemmatizer. That's it. so I will just do ps dot stem and the word. And after doing this, so what I will do is I will just join this again. And I will add once each particular list value is done with the using part, I am again appending in something called as corpus. So corpus dot append input will be. Let's try to run this. Let's see that what I have done is correct or not. Okay. So this will be sentence dot I, not list dot I. Agree. So it will be sentence so if I proceed enter now
n is missing.
So now you can, so there is something called sentences and there is something called corpus. Okay, let's try to differentiate between the sentences and the corpus now. So double click on corpus, open the window, shift towards the left, and open sentences, shift towards the right, and then open corpus. So this was the previous sentence. On the left hand side was the previous, okay, or the previous sentence which you have done only but sentence tokenization. And on the right hand side is the clean text. On the right hand side is clean text. Okay, so for example, I have three visions for India was the original text. Now the clean text is the three visions India. In 300 years of our history, people from all over the and something like that, 300 years history, people world come invade us, and basically it is converting into everything into root form. So the stem form, because I am using a porter stemmer, so it will convert everything into a stem form. So you can use either stemmer or lemmatization, up to you what you want to use. Okay, it's up to, totally up to you. But the idea is clear to everyone that what we have done till now. So if you want to see the code, just see the code what I have done. If you have any doubt, just ask me. So this what I have done in inside a for loop, and this for loop is clear to everyone.
Yeah.
Okay. Now what we'll do is we will try to convert this sentence into a vector form. Okay. So in a bag of words, what are the steps that we follow? So the first step is text processing that we have done. Then what is next step?
Make a vocabulary.
Okay. And after the vocabulary, just fill in the table based on the vocabulary. If the word is present, put 1. If the word is not present, put 0. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So what I will do is, so basically we don't have to do all that step. That is already done in a package called as bag of count vectorizer. So we have to import that package first. Okay. So creating a bag of word model, you can say, or you can say bag of word model. Yeah, model. Then from, so how to import this? Okay, so in NLTK, sorry, in SKLearn, so this is a feature of SKLearn. Okay, in SKLearn, we have something called as feature extraction dot text. Okay, so this is a class, this is a function for that class. Okay, and so SKLearn feature extraction dot text import count vectorizer. Okay, so there's something called as count vectorizer that is equivalent to bag of words. So just change the name, okay? But the function what it does behind the scene is exactly the same. So how to import bag of word? So you have to call sklearn.featureextraction.text import count vectorizer. So once we have done this, so basically we have to call the object first because it's a class. So count vectorizer. So count vectorizer, and call the class. And the simple thing what you have to do is just create one variable x and do cv.fit transform. That's it. This is the only thing you have to do. So this method you have seen in standard scalar or normalization, where if you want to convert it something into standard or normal way, you do fit. So what is the difference between fit and fit transform? Anyone tell me?
It just fits. It transform does fit and transform.
Okay. 957. Okay.
Like why there is a set of?
Why there is a?
It's not boring.
Set just to be on the safe side. If anything is repeating in a stop word, just consider it the one thing. That's it. So set, you can repetition or set. Repetition is not allowed in set, right? If you remember.
Yeah.
So just for that, just be on a safe side. That's it. If it's your choice. If you want, if you do, if you don't, don't.
Okay. Can you please share this for loop along in chat?
This loop?
Yeah.
Okay. Copy. Paste. So till here, give to everyone what I have done.
Yes.
So I will do the purpose. Okay. Now if I run this. Okay. So I have got one more variable called as x. Okay. Now the problem is that this x is a matrix, okay? So to see this matrix, you have to use something called as two array, okay? So I hope you have learned this, what is two array in pandas or data frame. So two array will convert that everything into array. So two array. And once you do this, and then run this, shift tab. And everything is converted into the vector form. So this is what I was saying. This is what I showed you with the help of the tables and everything. So this is how it's calculated. So all the values has converted into 0 and 1s. And this on the top, what is this column? Anyone?
Which one?
The column. Basically, what is the column in a when you convert into vector form? All the list.
Each word.
Okay, each vocabulary that you have created. And on the left hand side, it is the sentences. Okay, so basically this everything is a corpus, and 0, 1, 2 is a document, if you remember the term. And 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is nothing but a features or the vocabulary that you have created. So this is what exactly we have done in the last class, and this is with the practical session. So now are you able to relate?
Can you please show the code for this
Yes. So what you have to do is the first step what you have to do is you have to call the count vectorizer. So count vectorizer is the name given to bag of words. Okay, so don't get confused that I am using something else. No. Then you have to call the object of that particular count vectorizer, and then you have to do fit transform. The same thing what you have learned in machine learning, the same I am doing here. Okay, so cv.fit_transform corpus.2array. So behind the scene, it will just find the vocabulary and it will try to convert everything to vector form and to arrays to so that we can see the value in a array form. So that's the only thing we have done here.
Okay, got it. Thanks.
Can you just copy paste this last three line?
Afsan, will it still work if I just use fit instead of fit transform?
It will work, but fit will only try to learn, okay? It will not transform your data into that. That is the difference. If you do this fit, if you run this, if you go to Explorer, okay, this is saved, so I will do X, Y. Okay. So see what fit will do. It will not show you any output. So if you print Y also, it will not show any output. There is a concept of fit and fit transformed in machine learning that you have learned. So that concept, it will work here.
Okay.
So once you do fit, so what happens on this corpus? It is learned. It is learning everything, but you have to apply that on corpus also, right? So what you have to do is, so you have done fit. So your why has learned something, that what is the vocabulary and everything, okay? Now, but it is not applying on corpus, because you have not telling him to apply on corpus. So he's just learning. If you want to apply that on corpus, you have to do transform. So you can do this way also. So why dot transform.
Transform, okay.
Transform and just put the corpus. That please transform this corpus for me based on what you have learned from this fit. So instead of using two at a time, what you can do is you can do fit underscore transform. So a shortcut.
Yep.
But in this the output was same. If you know you are not doing the transform, right?
Output is not same. No. So if we remove this, if we remove the transform. And if I run this, see, output is not same. What is output? See?
Okay.
You're getting something else only. Now, when you do fit transform to array, now the output will be different. So, see, now it is converted into proper text, proper this matrix form or the vector form. So, the output is not same. Okay, so just revise this concept of fit transform, okay, so it will be clear. So this count vectorizer or the backover is clear to everyone?
Yep.
Okay. And now what is the difference between a bag of words and TF-IDF? Exactly. Okay, so basically in bag of words, if you notice, the answer will be in 0 and 1s. In TF-IDF, it will be between 0 and 1. This is a difference, okay? So let's try to see that also. So everything will be same. So everything what you have done here will be same. That's the only thing what I will do is I will just change this particular function. So I will not change this. Basically, I will in the DAW, I will create a TF-IDF model. So again, the same thing. So from sklearn dot feature extraction, dot feature extraction dot text import. Now here we have something called as TF-IDF vectorizer. Okay, so the name is maintained here. So TF-IDF vectorizer, and again just so TF equal to just call the object, just call the class, that's it, TF-IDF vectorizer, and just do fit transform. That's it. This is the only difference you have to do. Okay, so fit transform. So copy this, paste this. Instead of CV, just put TF and just put a variable called as Z for this. Now, if you try to run this, everything. So what I will do is I will open Y at one place and Z at one place. Okay, so this is Z that is open, and this is X. Now this is a difference between a count vectorizer and a TF-IDF.
Okay.
So TF-IDF is more precise.
TF-IDF, so basically why you use TF-IDF? Suppose, so I have told you in last class also, TF, the importance is of TF-IDF is it tries to give the weightage to the important words. In bag of words, see, everything is 1111. So which, so my machine learning will understand that which is the important feature here, right?
Yeah.
But here it is in form of 0 to 1. So my machine learning will understand that the 7 features is important for this particular row. So it will train on that. So it's like that. Okay. So the weightage is given to the each columns. So see, everything is a form of zeros and zero between 0 and 1. But in this, everything is form of 0 and 1. So the best method is go with TF-IDF always. Okay,
but
so
then the bag of words, I think even machine learning cannot learn from this because there is no weightage, right?
Yeah, there is no weightage. There is a weightage, but it is an equal weightage given to all the columns.
Correct. So then it will be difficult for the model, right?
Yeah, it will. Yes, exactly. That's why I have given two examples. So bag of words and TF-IDF, so that you can relate that which one is better and why one is better than another. So now can you relate that?
But always TF-IDF is better, right?
Yeah, always TF-IDF, always, anytime.
Okay.
So the demonstration of bag of words and TF-IDF is clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.